Hey there. Welcome back to another smart session on REXX programming with Topictrick. If you're learning scripting for mainframes or just want to simplify automation tasks, you're in the right place. And if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to our Topictrick channel. We've got plenty more useful content coming your way. All right, let's talk about something incredibly handy in REXX. Compound variables. These are like mini data containers that help you group and manage related information in a structured way. Think of them as REXX's version of arrays or simple hash maps, and they're way more flexible than you might expect. So what exactly is a compound variable? It's a variable made up of two parts, a stem and a tail. The stem is like the base name, and the tail is the unique part that follows. You join them together using a period. For example, score.player1 equals 80 or score.player2 equals 90. In both cases, score is the stem and player1 or player2 is the tail. This structure allows you to store multiple related values under one umbrella. Now, defining compound variables is just as simple as regular variables. No special declarations needed. Just assign a value and it's ready to go. You could have something like employee.name equals Alex and employee.id equal 1023. And REXX will treat each one as a separate variable under the employee family. Here's where it gets really interesting. When the tail part is dynamic, like a changing number, you can use compound variables to simulate arrays. For instance, in a loop, you could do something like item.1 equals apple, item.2 equals banana, item.3 equals cherry, and so on. You can even use a variable as the tail, like item.i equals grapes, where I is a loop counter. That's REXX giving you powerful, flexible indexing without needing a formal array structure. If you use just the stem name with a period, like item, you're actually referring to the entire set of compound variables that share that stem. This is really useful when you want to process all related variables together, like clearing them, looping over them, or checking if any exist. Now let's touch on the rules. A stem name must follow standard variable naming conventions. It can't start with a digit or a dot, and it's not case sensitive. The tail, on the other hand, can be made up of any string or value that resolves to a valid variable name. It doesn't even need to be a number. You can have user.email, user.address, or user.phone, whatever makes sense for your data. Also, keep in mind that compound variables are not arrays in the strictest programming sense. They don't have a fixed size, and there's no built-in function to return the number of elements. But for practical scripting purposes, they work just like arrays, and that makes them super useful in day-to-day automation tasks. So to sum it up, compound variables in REXX are a powerful way to manage structured or repeatable data using a simple dot notation. They're easy to define, flexible to use, and make your scripts way more organized and readable. Thanks for tuning in. If you found this helpful, hit that like button, leave a comment with your questions, and don't forget to subscribe to Topictrick for more clean and practical tutorials. See you in the next one.